Hey Bowtie Nation, Joseph Hogue here, and a really important video that I know is going to change how a lot of you think about dividend stocks. You know, I'm a big fan of dividends, but every dividends video, I always get a lot of comments about returns. You know, questions about why I invest in dividends instead of those higher returns in growth stocks. And it is a totally valid question. You know, growth stocks do often outperform dividends. For example, the Invesco QQQ Trust, a fund of tech stocks, has beaten the Vanguard Dividend Appreciation Fund, that's ticker VIG, by nearly 10% over the last year. So why are dividend stocks so important? Why not just invest in that growth instead? And why do I think dividend stocks are the better investment when you need to live off your portfolio? But to answer that, I have to take you all the way back to 1986. My mom and I are at Kmart late September finishing up some back to school shopping, and she tells me to go look at jeans while she does something else. Now, I am not sure if my mom's getting early onset dementia at just 34 years old or what, but a 10-year-old boy is not gonna go look at clothes while his mom does some mystery shopping. So I do my best Miami Vice, a loose follow as she makes her way over to the toys. My heart beating faster, knowing I'm about to see what I'm getting for Christmas a full 3 months early. She asks a store associate something, and he leads her over to aisle 5, action figures. And now what she does next, after the birth of my kids, is probably the single best moment of my life. My mom picks up the G.I. Joe Terradome off the shelf and proceeds to layaway. Now understand, I had been asking for this holy grail of the G.I. Joe Pantheon for months, and most years I would make a big ask like this in hopes of getting the consolation prize, you know, something smaller like a couple of comic books. But this year, I was getting the grand prize. You see, my mom had just remarried in January, and for the first time I could remember, we were a two-income family swimming in cash. Like, not quite Different Strokes or Silver Spoons living, but definitely Who's the Boss money. I got new clothes for school that year. I mean, they were still garage sale clothes, but these were nice garages, like really nice. And here I was, about to add the Terror Dome, the Pride of Cobra, to my arsenal of action figures. And this thing was awesome. A Fortress of Terror complete with the Firebat jet and pilot, the battles would be epic. Then, in one of the defining moments of my childhood, in late October, the world ended. Now, not the actual world, of course, but my 10-year-old world and hopes of late night G.I. Joe raids deep into Cobra territory, because within 2 weeks of each other, both my parents got laid off from their jobs. Now, my dad was able to get a temp job as a janitor pretty quick, but we lost one of the cars and started falling behind on the other bills. And I remember vividly my mom and I sitting in her old cream-colored 78 Nova, not the sweet muscle car of the early 70s, but the grandma coupe that it would later become. We're sitting in the car about 9 p.m. one night waiting for my dad to get off work, and she turns to me and she says, "Let's talk about money." And that was it. Not only was I not getting the Terror Dome for Christmas, but I instantly learned the value of financial security and having money you can count on in a crisis. So when people ask me why I invest in dividend stocks, when they point out that growth stocks often produce those higher returns over time, that's the point that I flash back to, that 5 seconds sitting in the car back in 1986 when I learned that you just can't put a price on financial stability. And that's the power of dividend stocks, that consistency, that security to pay the bills, even when you can't. In this video, I'll show you how to create a dividend ladder to live off your dividend stocks. I'll reveal 3 passive income dividend investments and 5 stocks to buy. Then I'm gonna show you a plan for starting small, investing just a few hundred a month that's gonna grow to a dividend portfolio you can count on. We're getting started, but you know I've gotta send that special shout out to all you out there in the nation. Thank you for spending a part of your day to be here. If you're not part of that community yet, just click that little red subscribe button. It's free and you'll never miss an episode. Now the idea here is gonna be to highlight different types of passive income dividend investments, then 5 dividend stocks as an example for that dividend ladder portfolio. And we wanna pick dividend investments that are gonna be reliable and produce that consistently high dividend yield to live on. And first here, we'll look at special structured dividend investments, the REITs and the BDCs. Now these are special types of companies that get tax breaks if they spin off at least 90% of their income as dividends. The result is you get a great dividend stock with a high yield, but there is a downside here. Now a lot of investors, they just focus on that dividend yield and they end up loading up exclusively on these types of stocks. The problem is though that if something happens to the sector, so maybe the market for commercial real estate or for small business lending, then you can see your entire portfolio sell off all at once. So to avoid that, we want to look for regular dividend stocks here as well, one with higher yields than the market, but still that normal corporate structure. And for these, I usually like to look for yields between 4% to as high as 6%, but we're not looking for those big double-digit yields. You want a company that can produce that consistent dividend, but it's still holding something back from its earnings to grow the company and eventually grow the dividend as well. And within your dividend stocks, you also want to look for the dividend growth rate. So how much the dividend payout has grown over the last 3 or 5 years. And this is a great way to build your portfolio because you know besides that strong dividend yield, you're also going to get a stock that's going to pay that higher dividend in the future. Now, finally, before I reveal those 5 stocks to buy, I want to highlight another dividend strategy, one we've talked about on the channel before, the covered call strategy. Now, this is where you own a stock and you sell call options against it, collecting cash flow besides that dividend. And here, the reason why I like to use this strategy is it can give you a way to boost that dividend yield another couple of percent on stocks that you really like, but maybe don't meet that criteria for the higher yields. For example, you might really like shares of Apple, but it only pays a 0.5% dividend yield. Definitely not something you can live on. But here I can sell these call options expiring in January 2023 for $8.75 each. I collect that money now, effectively giving me another 4% annual cash boost, and I still have that 27% upside return potential to the $190 strike price. But let's look at examples of each of these types of passive income dividends. 5 stocks with an average yield of 6%, plus a return of 24% annually over the last decade. And first up is one of the best real estate stocks for returns and yield, Arbor Realty Trust, ticker ABR, with its 7.7% dividend yield. Arbor is a direct lender to multifamily, senior housing, healthcare, and other commercial real estate properties. And multifamily projects make about 83% of the portfolio, so it's a little on the high side, but these are agency-backed loans, so definitely on the safe side here. Arbor has grown that dividend by 16% annually over the last 5 years, and on sales growth of 20% a year. And with the rise in residential prices, rents on multifamily should be growing as well, and loan growth should continue higher. The shares have produced a 28% annual return over the last 5 years, and I think these could easily continue to produce in the range of 15 to 20% annually. Main Street Capital, ticker MAIN, is another favorite among dividend investors for its 6% yield and solid price return. Main Street is a business development corporation, so specializing in those loans and equity investments to mid-sized businesses, and with shares producing an 18% annual return over the last decade. And the company has regularly increased its dividend as well, now at 20 cents a share, along with special dividends of $4 a share distributed since 2013. The company had 182 portfolio investments as of the second quarter, with the largest representing just 3% of the total fair value. So a hit to any of these investments isn't going to hurt the shares that much. But now one thing you always want to watch for in these BDC stocks is to compare the effective yield on the company's investments with the dividend yield it's paying out. Now in this case, Main Street earns a weighted average yield of 9.7% on its loan investments and then pays out a 6% annual dividend paid out monthly. Now, the average yield above that committed dividend yield is a must for dividend sustainability. One of my favorite dividend stocks here for cash return and growth has been AllianceBernstein, ticker AB, and its 6.7% yield. Now, Alliance isn't one of the larger wealth managers at just $105 billion in assets, but it is one of the best managed. That high dividend yield has steadily grown with a 14% growth rate over the last 5 years, and shares have produced a 24% annual return over the last decade. And one thing you do need to understand about Bernstein is that it pays out 100% of its adjusted earnings, so that dividend tends to be pretty volatile up and down. Still though, the company has a great history of growing revenue with 9.7% sales growth over the last 3 years on that shift to higher fee alternative investment management. Clients also stick around here with an average client tenure of 12 years. Next here is possibly one of the best opportunities in dividend stocks, OneMain Holdings, ticker OMF, with its 4.8% yield. OneMain is a consumer lender with over 100 years of operating history, serving over 2 million customers and originating more than $155 billion in loans. And despite the share price nearly doubling in the past year, the industry for consumer loans has actually been pretty tough. With households saving as much as 33% of their income during the pandemic, loan demand just dried up for banks and other lenders. We're now seeing that come back though, and I really like the direction the company is taking. OneMain has an impressive 20% market share on a market opportunity that approaches $500 billion. The acquisition of the Trim app puts it in that fintech financial wellness space for growth outside of credit and really makes it a more diversified business. Management is guiding to double the customer base by 2025 and generating $1.5 billion in capital growth. That would build on the stock's 25% annual return we've seen over the past 5 years, including a $14 a share in cumulative dividends. In that covered call strategy, the yield on Progressive Corporation here, ticker PGR, is a little misleading because it actually pays out a total of around 5% yield. Progressive is the third largest auto insurance company in the United States and has more than 20 million policies across auto, home, and commercial. And the company pays out a special dividend each January that actually accounts for the majority of its cash return and has grown the dividend by 32% annually since 2019 on sales growth of 16% a year. And I'll show you how to set up this covered call strategy with this example, a strategy that can boost your dividend yield by 2% on shares of Progressive. Now, you're first going to go to the options menu, and we'll use Yahoo Finance here, but you can find this on any investing app. The first thing you'll do here is pick which month you want your options to expire. Now, I like using the January months because I can lock in that premium for up to a year and collect more money on these. I'll pick the January 2022 options, which expire in about 5 months from now. And next, you pick the price at which you would be willing to sell your shares. Now, since it's only 5 months to January, I don't think Progressive would go much higher than maybe another 15%. So that gives us a price of around $110 per share. And I see here, at the $110 strike price, I can sell these call options to another investor and receive about 90 cents a share right now. That is an instant return of about 0.9%, almost 1% for 5 months. So if I annualize that, it's like getting an additional 2.2% annual yield on this stock. Now, there is more to that covered call strategy, so I'm going to link to a full video in the description below, but essentially, I've just increased the yield on that stock that already pays a 5% dividend by another 2%, plus I've still got that upside price potential. So here we've got a 5-stock dividend portfolio with annual returns averaging 24% over the last decade and a 6% dividend yield. But more importantly, I've picked these to create a dividend ladder for that constant cash flow. I'll show you a plan for building your dividend portfolio and then living off your dividends next, but a dividend ladder is really just consciously picking your dividend stock so you receive that cash flow every month or at least regularly. You see, most dividend stocks only pay out every 3 months, but that's just not how bills work, right? You've got bills to pay every single month, so unless you want to save parts of that quarterly cash flow, the best strategy here is creating that kind of a ladder effect on your dividends. And this is easier than you might think. You can find which months a dividend stock pays out by going to the historical data tab on Yahoo Finance, or this dividend history is going to be available on any app. So here we are on Arbor Realty, and we'll change the time period to 5 years to get a good look at its history. Then we'll change it to show only dividends and then click apply. Here you see the ex-dividend date for each dividend, and it's not the same day each year, but usually within a week. We see that Arbor Realty tends to go ex-dividend in February, May, August, and November, with these dividends paid out usually about 1 to 2 weeks thereafter. So if we want to create that dividend ladder, then all we have to do is pick stocks that not only produce a strong yield and a return, but ones that are going to pay out in different months. And if we look through these 5 stocks, we get good coverage throughout the year on those dividends. Progressive pays out an annual special dividend in January, and Main Street Capital is a monthly payer, so we know we're always going to get at least one dividend check each month. The other three will produce checks in 7 more months, so you might have to plan out a little bit for those lighter months, but you know you're never too far away from a big dividend payment. Again, though, these are only examples, and feel free to add or subtract stocks from your own dividend list. The important point is to be aware of when those dividend payments come out so you can plan your bills around them and have that sense of financial security. Now, if you want to go a step beyond this, I've put together another video highlighting a 12-stock dividend portfolio that pays out every week. 12 dividend stocks planned out to put cash in your pocket every single week, so look for that link in the video description below. And before I reveal that plan to live off your dividends, I want to personally invite you to get the Daily Bowtie, our daily market newsletter with all the news, trends, and investing strategies you need to know. It goes out every night before the market opens, giving you time to plan your investing day, so look for that link below as well. Now though, I want to reveal that plan to grow a dividend stock portfolio and then live off your dividends. But understand here, I am not going to promise you rainbows and unicorns. I cannot perform miracles. You see, there are plenty of dividend videos here on YouTube making it seem like you can live off your dividends within a few years, and a lot of investors think there's some fairy tale, magic, make-believe land where everyone gets free money for nothing. And I hate to burst your bubble here, folks, because if you think you're going to live off your dividends after investing just a few thousand bucks, It just ain't gonna happen, even on that 6% average dividend yield in our 5-stock example, which is an extremely high dividend, more than 3 times the market average. To create $3,000 a month in dividends, you would need to build a portfolio of $600,000 in these stocks. But before you throw up your hands and click out of the video, it is completely possible to build up to that amount in 10 or 15 years. I'll show you how to do that next, and at that 6% dividend yield, it's gonna produce a $3,000 monthly income for life. Every year, you're gonna be able to count on $36,000 in dividends and more as those dividend payouts and your portfolio grows. And now if you're still watching, half of you are wondering, how the hell can anyone live off $3,000 a month? I know, all my New York and California bowtie brothers and sisters, but you can use this strategy for any amount. To find the amount of dividends that you're gonna collect each month, you just take the amount you have invested and multiply that by the dividend yield of your stock or the entire portfolio. So in our example, with a 6% average dividend across those 5 stocks, if we have $500,000 in the portfolio, then 500 grand times 0.06 gives us $30,000 a year, and it divided by 12 gives you $2,500 a month in income. Now the secret to this strategy is gonna be reinvesting your dividends every month, every quarter, whenever you get paid, to grow that portfolio to the point where you can start living off the cash flow. As an example here, if you need that $3,000 in monthly income to live off, or at least supplement your other income, you can gradually build to that $600,000 portfolio. Here, if you start investing $500 a month, and I've tried to start here with a level that most people can achieve, that's gonna give you 4 years before you need to increase that monthly investment to $750. Then that's gonna give you another 4 years before increasing it one more time to $1,000 a month. That alone gets you to $593,000 within 15 years on a pretty reasonable return. And honestly, folks, 15 years is not a long time. I know it might seem like a long time compared to some of those other videos that promise overnight riches, but this is realistic. This is something you can do, not have to chase after the riskiest stocks that are gonna lose your money and not have to break your budget investing. This is a real plan for creating that dividend ladder and then living off your dividends. Click on the video to the right for a dividend portfolio that cash flows every week. 12 dividend stocks to buy that are gonna put cash in your pocket every single week. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.